It's different than going to a food pantry. It's the dignity part of it, where they can drive up and get their food. And
if you're in a pinch or you've had, you know, a life change or issue, it's a great place to come to receive much needed food and also just some great people to be around and able to talk and to just lift your spirits.
It helps you stretch your grocery budget for the month.
You can get a hot meal, get some groceries, can't beat it.
You know, while there's a material need, there's also a need to feel some love and affection and just make sure that people's days are being brightened and that they're doing more than just going through the motions of life, but they're actually going about it with meaning and purpose, and I think Good in the Hood really brings that to the table.
Good in the Hood was founded in 2003, and we provide several services and programs in the Twin Cities, including Bloomington, of course. Our mission statement is to influence, inspire, and impact individuals, families, entire communities for good. Some of our programs include, of course, our food programs.
Our Food in the Hood program here at Cedar Valley, we distribute the first and the third Tuesday of every month. Our client guests come in from 5 to 8 p.m. And it really is it's a beautiful center here in that we provide groceries. It's about a week's worth of groceries. We provide a hot meal. And really here, there's a lot of community building because people sit and they eat a meal together.
They all can eat, drink, and you actually make friends. These people, a lot of these clients are my friends now.
We have bus events that go out and provide areas of need with shoes through our shoe bus and through our shoe trailer.
Shoe Away Hungers is just what it sounds like. We have a food distribution program, 27 different sites around the metro, feeding about 100,000 people a year. To fund that, we sell gently used or new shoes that are donated through schools, businesses, and churches. We sell the shoes for $5 adults, $2 children. So it's a really good deal. No shoe that we sell is worth less than $20 usually. But the beauty of it is, we can give away shoes, by the way. But for people who purchase the shoes, especially if they thank us, we can translate quickly. If they bought two pairs of shoes, $10, we can tell them you fed four people for a week. The receiver becomes a giver through our program. And it helps to lift up a person's sense of value. And that's what I love about it.
We also have a very unique program called Soul Care for Souls. And that's a program that provides medical foot care for those that are maybe underserved or those that are living in shelters.
We do foot soaks and we take off calluses, cut the nails, maybe do corns. If they have blisters, fix those up. We always give them new socks and then we provide a foot massage for them when they are finished with their cares. We also ask them what their prayer concerns are, and we tell them that we'll pray for them for 1 week. We have a prayer team that does do that, and we've seen numerous prayers answered, and it really is a comfort for the people. It's soul care, foot care for souls.
What we try to do is intentional acts of kindness. We want to make sure that everybody is treated like a somebody. And so with that in mind, we want to go and offer goodness and kindness and personal attention to those who are in need of help. More important than help, we want to give them hope. And so what we love to do is be able to work in partnership with local groups that care, churches and businesses and volunteers who want to make a difference by treating everyone like a someone, and that's Good in the Hood.
I do the registration. I have done it 8 years, twice a month, and never missed.
I felt that they were nice enough to help me with food when I needed food, so I felt it was no more than right that I helped them back, and the only way I could help them back was with volunteering.
Most of the volunteers we have that work with us to help prepare the food and so forth are the people in need. They'll leave with food as well. So there's this blending between the giver and receiver. There's just not that distinction anymore.
They're extremely friendly, extremely loving, and you know, there's no shame or embarrassment when you come into these doors. We're all just here serving each other as human beings, serving human beings.
If you're in need of food, if you're in need of friendship, if you just need someone to really care about you and talk with you, we would love to have you come. Receive shoes, receive medical care on your feet, to be able to get groceries, build relationships and friendships. This is a very safe space. We love everybody, we accept everybody, and really would like to see anyone who has need to be able to come in and know that there's groceries that are available so that you don't have to go hungry.
Just want to say thank you to our community. Thank you to Bloomington. The city of Bloomington has been wonderful. Thank you to our partners who are right here in Bloomington. For those that are interested in learning more about Good in the Hood, we have, of course, a website, goodinthehood.org, and we have a program page, we have a volunteer page. Those who want to contribute in some way, we, of course, will accept donations. We always love it, though, when people will not only join us financially, but we really want people to join us as volunteers. We love participants. We love engaging people and letting them make a difference with intentional kindness. And they can do that, of course, right here in Bloomington, which we're very proud to be a part of this wonderful community, but also throughout the Twin Cities. And so people can get on board with a shoe drive, and get on board donating shoes, being a part of a shoe event, with a food event, donating groceries. Of course, the holidays, where we collect gift cards, groceries, and gifts for those in need. And, of course, emergency food packs for those that are unsheltered. And just basic school supplies or winter wear for those in need. So there's so many ways people can get involved, either by a collection, by donating, or, of course, contributing and investing their time. We really believe in making a difference. We'd love for people to join us in this, making a difference for the community. And so from Good in the Hood, from the many that we get to serve, thank you so much, Bloomington.